Howdy there, folks, and welcome into today's video. Hope you guys are doing great out there as always. So TTCF, the Tattooed Chef, as we call it on this channel, the chef. It is on its way to making a big upward move. In this video here today, I want to get into two core things, okay? I want to get into basically explaining what is happening with Tattooed Chef stock right now that I think a lot of people don't even realize is going on. Even a lot of people that are invested in the stock, I don't even think a lot of folks that are investing in the stock know what is actually going on underlying. They know about this company. It's a plant-based food company. It's exciting. It's expanding all over the United States. International plans long term. They're buying out companies. So exciting. The growth is amazing, right? But I don't think a lot of folks even know what is actually happening at the underbelly here, okay? And we're also gonna get into what shorts are missing in the situation, because the shorts, oh my gosh, okay? We're gonna talk a little bit about that as well. So hope you guys enjoy this video. As always, everybody that's in the Smash Squad, I appreciate you guys. Everybody that smashed that like button each and every video, I appreciate you guys in a massive, massive way. And the short sellers of Tattoo Chef stock, the people that want this stock to go to $0, okay? You know, you guys, even you, smash the like button, okay? I'm telling you, it's gonna be such a good feeling to you. I know it's not fun to be on the opposite side of this trade, but I'm telling you, okay, it will feel good for you to smash that like button. I appreciate you guys for watching this video as well, okay? And I wanna let you guys know, if you haven't tried out the Hungry Bowl app yet, the Hungry Bowl, it is climbing up the app charts, okay? Absolutely amazing. If you haven't got to try it out yet, go ahead and try it out. Just search it on your iOS or your Android device, type in the Hungry Bowl, it'll pop up there for you. You can track stocks, you can listen to conference calls right inside the app, you can look at some financial data, as well as read our daily newsletter, and we have so many more things coming down the road. It's amazing. We're still kind of in beta test mode, so, you know, tweaking a few things here and there, but within the next 1 to 2 weeks, we're really gonna be ready for full launch. And the other day in the private stock group, I had posted something in there, and then somebody made this meme. I thought the meme was funny, okay? I don't know if everybody's gonna get that meme, but I thought it was funny, okay? Also, if you want to check out the private stock group, the private Discord chat, if you're looking to scale your portfolio to much higher numbers, things like that, check out the pinned comment down there. Correct, the pinned comment. And also, if you join us in the private stock group and the private Discord chat, make sure you say hello in the Tattooed Chef stock chat if you basically own the stock, okay? And also, make sure you check out the product picks. We have everybody in the private stock group every time they go to stores taking pictures of the new sections in a lot of these different stores. It's a lot of dang fun. It's a lot of dang fun if you own the stock. If you don't own the stock yet, but you're like, I probably don't care about that, okay? Alrighty, guys, let's get into this. So first off here, Tattooed Chef is reporting second quarter 2021 fiscal results on August 12th. That is exactly 10 days from recording this video, okay? Big, big earnings. Now, short sellers, the shorts are like, man, if they miss those earnings, that stock's crashing back to $15. It's going right back down there, right? Which, if we look back, this stock was at the $15 range back in December, and it was also in the $15 range back in April, okay? And so the shorts are like, yeah, this baby's about to just crash right back down to $15, all right? If we look at what is expected, the company's expected to do $54 million of revenue in the current quarter. That's gonna be huge growth year over year. 64 mil next quarter. Now, I will go on record saying I will not be surprised at all if the company beats both of those numbers, okay? And beats the current year. So current year, the company is expected to do 239 mil. I will not be surprised at all if they do 250 plus this year, okay? And so what short sellers think is they think, like big investors like myself that have, you know, seven figures in the stock, they think, oh, we're gonna panic sell on that earnings day. Like, they missed a number. Oh, sell, okay? But what big investors are actually gonna do in the stock, we're gonna look at those numbers, and we're gonna smile, and, you know, does it really matter if the company, if 54 mil is expected, does it matter if the company does 51 mil, 54 mil, 57 mil, 60 mil? More than likely, no. Us big investors that are long-term shareholders of this company and plan to hold this for years to go in the future, which is a huge section of us, like, we're gonna buy the stock don't matter what. Like, if the stock is down for whatever reason, Guess what we're gonna do? Buy. If the stock's up, guess what we're gonna do? Buy. If the stock doesn't do anything, guess what we're gonna do? Buy, okay? So I don't think the shorts quite understand that concept. They think a lot of big investors like myself in the stock are just gonna be like, gotta sell. Oh, they didn't report good enough earnings. I gotta sell the stock today. Like, that's not what's gonna happen at all, okay? Maybe some people that might be playing it from a short-term perspective will do that, but most of us that are in the stock for the long term, if they do 51, 60 mil, 62 mil, 54 mil, we don't care. We're in this for years to go in the future. So if they beat by a little bit, miss by a little bit, come in line, to us, it really doesn't matter, okay? You have certain types of stocks in the stock market, right? You have hype stocks. Hype stocks are stocks in which there's something going on short term and everybody's all of a sudden backing it, thinking this is gonna be some huge thing, and it builds a ton of hype, okay? A perfect example was, Virgin Galactic, for instance, right? There was a lot of excitement about this launch they had, right? And then the stock actually didn't go up after that successful launch with Richard Branson and all the publicity. Stock actually went down a bunch, okay? But that's hype. There's a lot of excitement around what was something that was gonna happen in the short term, and if it went well, the stock was gonna shoot up even more, right? That's hype, and sometimes you get into hype stocks, okay? Then you have your growth stocks. Very, very nice growth. The companies that are growing 20% plus per year. You have your value stocks that are just solid, right? They might grow 3%, 5% revenues a year, but they have beautiful net incomes, beautiful business models. You have your dividend stocks, which people love because they love to make that cash flow money coming in their accounts, right? Which they can buy more dividend stocks or just other stocks in general. And the last group of stocks you have in the stock market are what are called cult stocks. No one really likes to talk about these too much in respect of calling them cult stocks, but they do exist. They're few and far between, but when they emerge, they are absolutely special. Tesla is a cult stock. Netflix is a cult stock. Amazon is a cult stock. Shopify is a cult stock. There are certain stocks in the stock market that emerge, and these stocks can be across many different industries, but when these stocks emerge, it is not about the short-term numbers. People are in these type of stocks for years to go in the future. They're not worried about what they're gonna report tomorrow for earnings or something like that. That's not how it works. And so Tattooed Chef, TTCF, this is an early days cult stock emergence. I see everything is lining up, going after a huge, massive, growing industry that's changing rapidly. They're innovating faster than anybody we've seen in the food space in modern history. And this stock is emerging as a cult stock. And it's a $1 billion something dollar market cap. And so, as the shorts are looking at this and they're trying to understand it on a short-term basis when they're totally missing everything going on. When it comes to Tesla stock, the big long-term investor is the Tesla stock, right? They don't care about the next quarter for Tesla. They care about the next 5 to 10 years for Tesla. Whether Tesla misses their car estimates a little bit or beats it a little bit or comes in line, it doesn't matter. People are in Tesla for years to go in the future. They want to hold that stock till 2030, maybe take it to the grave. They don't care. They're in that for the long, long term, right? And so Tesla can trade at very, very high PEs, and the shorts can look at that and be like, this is ridiculous. This stock deserves to crash 50%, 70%, whatever, right? And they just don't understand the investor base doesn't care about the short-term metrics. They care about this company ramping to hundreds of billions of dollars of revenue over the coming years, and maybe even long-term a trillion, right? And speaking about a trillion-dollar company, Amazon, another perfect example. Amazon is well-established. Amazon's been around since the 90s, right? And they just continue to grow and grow over that time. And the stocks always trade rich from the first time I ever looked into Amazon stock until literally today. The stock always trades at a P/E ratio that is significantly, significantly higher than anything the market's trading at. Here today, it trades at a 57, 58 for a company that's been around since the 90s, right? But they've always had amazing growth. And at the end of the day, this stock is a cult stock. It has a following around it where the big investors aren't selling Amazon if they miss earnings, beat earnings, anything like that, right? The short-term traders can make those moves and make the stock go up for up or down for a day or something like that. But at the end of the day, the big investors, if the stock dips, you know what they do when it comes to Amazon? They buy more shares. They don't sell them, okay? Netflix, another perfect example. Netflix, you know, I've always looked at Netflix, and yeah, the company's amazing, but it's always traded at extremely big valuations compared to where the market trades at. But Netflix is a cult stock. People are not in that just based upon what's going on today. They're thinking about streaming of games and then the streaming service over years just getting bigger and bigger. And despite Netflix having a lot of short-term headwinds, right, around basically the last 18 months, they had a huge ramp up in business that pulled some demand forward, and the company has a lot of short-term headwinds. There's no doubt around Netflix. The longs that are really in that stock don't care. They don't care. They're in that for the long term. And so when it comes to Tattooed Chef, company trades at Ford PS68. The shorts can say, oh my gosh, that's ridiculous, right? And it's at a 68 Ford P. The market in general trades at maybe a 20 or an 18 Ford P, something like that. You got to understand, Tattooed Chef is expected to grow revenues, what, 60% this year, roughly, if not higher than that. Also, that Ford P could be low. And lastly, remember, people are paying up for the huge growth that Tattooed Chef should have for the next 5, 10 plus years. And the company going on its way to becoming a food giant. It's a $1 billion something dollar company with 9 figures of cash on the balance sheet with massive expansion opportunity, and they're proving their brand is successful. Target, what did Target say? What, the best frozen food launch in the history of Target? You don't get these massive retailers just taking all this product in, all these SKUs, without having the numbers behind you, okay? And the chef has the numbers, all right? Now, 2022, this is extremely important. This is what a lot of folks are not even seeing when it comes to stock. 2022 is the year Tattooed Chef, the chef, gets on Wall Street's radar. It is not this year, it is next year. This stock is gonna emerge on Wall Street's radar like never before, okay? You're already getting some small indications, right? This is like a week or two ago, lady calls up, asked for Cramer's opinion on Mad Money about Tattooed Chef stock on CNBC, okay? That's just a very initial kind of like get the ball rolling type thing when you start seeing stuff like that, okay? And more going forward, you're gonna see more and more Wall Street attention on the stock. There's two analysts that are putting out numbers for the stock right now. Two, okay? There's gonna be 5 to 10 analysts covering the stock, in my opinion, by the end of 2022, okay? Which is a massive increase. And so all of a sudden, all these analysts are covering the stock, and we'll get into why that's so important in just a moment. If you look at something like a Beyond Meat, look at this, you know, number of analysts, 16, 15, 18, 17. You know, Beyond Meat's a company that's covered by, let's say, between 15 and 18 analysts, maybe even more than that. And so the stock's always able to stay in the news cycle because analysts are upgrading, downgrading the stock, putting new price targets on, making their clients aware of Beyond Meat, and oh, we just upgraded Beyond Meat to a buy, we think it's going to $150, stuff like that, right? And so it's on Wall Street's radar, okay? Here's what you gotta know about this and why this is so important to get on Wall Street's radar, okay? The more analysts you have, you get way more attention on your stock. Why you get way more attention? The upgrades, the downgrades, the price target moves, the notes, the analysts going on big financial networks such as a CNBC and talking about some stocks that they think are buys, stuff like that, right? And so all of a sudden you get way more attention with more analysts covering the stock. And what does that mean? That means hedge funds, institutions, high net worth individuals can start buying the stock or considering the stock. And as you start having them money flow in, then you can start getting into more of, let's say, index funds, things like that. Don't be surprised if Tattooed Chef within the next 3 years is all of a sudden in the S&P 500, okay? These are things to consider. And when you get in something like, let's say, the S&P 500, all of a sudden the funds have to buy your stock. This is very, very important. I think it could even be in the next 2 years, Tattooed Chef gets in the S&P 500, but the next 3 years, I feel very comfortable making that predictions, okay? And so all of a sudden you have all this big money starting to consider buying your stock or actually buying your stock, okay? Now keep in mind, New York Wall Street, they're slow to react. Think about Tesla, they were so slow to react. I mean, one of the things that gave me such conviction around Tesla was not just looking at their product and looking at the pre-order numbers for Model 3 and stuff like that. My big thing was I was living out here on the West Coast, right? Living in Las Vegas, but also going to LA a couple times a year, also going to Phoenix, Arizona a couple times a year. And what I saw
every single time was more and more Teslas getting on the road and going to very, very nice communities here on the West Coast and seeing firsthand, like, people that have money are choosing to buy a Tesla car over other vehicles. They could buy whatever they want, and they're buying Teslas, they're buying Model X's, Model S's, and then all of a sudden the three start emerging. And so I saw this, and I'm looking at this, and it was amazing to me. Meanwhile, New York, Wall Street was super slow to react. They weren't seeing it right in front of their face, right? And so if I think about Tattooed Chef, I'm looking at another stock that Wall Street is slow to react on. This stock is not even on their radar right now, okay? Not even on their radar. Think about this, okay? Look at the top 10 hedge fund managers. Top 10 hedge fund managers earned $20 billion last year, okay? These fund managers make a fortune. Okay. Do you think these big fund managers are out there worried about Tattooed Chef and going to stores and trying to figure out? No, okay. They're trying to figure out if they're going to eat that Le Bernardin, okay? Are they going to eat that Jean George's maybe tonight, or Le Cuckoo? Maybe they eat that Le Cuckoo tonight. They're not walking the Walmart aisles and going in the frozen section and like, should I get some green bean blend tonight, or should I get some raced cauliflower quinoa Mediterranean style? They're not going to the Kroger stores and trying to figure out if they're going to buy a cauliflower crust pizza from Tattooed Chef or the cauliflower crust plant-based pepperoni. They're not going to the Target stores and going down the freezer aisles and looking at the bulls. They're not doing any of that, okay? They're not doing any of that. They're got way too much money to do anything like that, okay? The fund managers, what do the fund managers really focus on, guys? The fund managers focus on basically having relationships with high net worth individuals, companies, things like that, so they can keep investing the money, trying to get them a return that is somewhere in relation to the market, and keep making those fees and those fees and those fees, okay? They're not doing that type of research work. You know, Tattooed Chef isn't even close to being on these guys' radar yet, but the start happens next year in 2022, okay? So the moral of the story is, for the short sellers specifically, okay, is we're not cashing the stock. If the stock goes down, we're buying. If the stock doesn't do anything, we're buying. If the stock goes up, we're buying, okay? We're long-term shareholders. Somebody like myself is a long-term shareholder of the stock. I'm not getting caught up into No, that's not what we do. That's not what I'm doing, okay? And also, short sellers, understand, Wall Street money is coming. Wall Street loves a high growth story. Wall Street loves a strong brand. And guess what a Tattooed Chef has? A strong growing brand and a company that's growing massively into a massive growing sector, okay? And this is about to hit their radar in 2022, and it will just grow bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. And the shorts, you're gonna be in a whole lot of trouble, because guess what? When the stock goes to 30, I'm not selling. And when it goes to 40, I'm not selling. I don't care to sell, okay? That's the bottom line with this one. Way too much upside long-term. I think this is gonna be a $10 billion plus dollar company. And so, you know, if it goes to 2 billion, 3 billion, 4 billion, who cares, man? It doesn't even hit my radar to sell the stock, okay? Thanks so much for joining me today, guys. I appreciate you as always. Much love. If you wanna join us in the private stock group, the private Discord chat, you wanna check that out and apply for that, check out the pinned comment down there. Don't forget to download the Hungry Bowl, add your watch list, and start enjoying that as well. Completely free to use the Hungry Bowl app. Thank you for watching, and have a great day.